Welcome back to Game 2 of Evil Geniuses versus the newcomers Team Vasavi. Game 1 didn't turn out quite so well for them, as Evil Geniuses was able to take that in a quick, like, 25-minute game or something like that. But Team Vasavi did have a small moment to shine. First 5 minutes of the game, they had a 1,000 gold lead. Not bad at all against pretty much the top American team. So we'll see whether or not Team Vasavi have some interesting strats available to them. Game 1 certainly was very, very interesting. Only could do that in 6.81, man. And let's get into the draft, Shelmy. And welcome in my co-caster, Mr. Rio Burrows, is going to be joining me once again of E-Hug fame as well as Super Stand-In.
Oh, yeah. I'm so famous now. Woo-hoo.
You're a moderator. I'm joined out of red. It doesn't get any better than that.
I know. And I get to cast with Capitalist.
Unless you have access to the owner account, in which case,
oh,
that's the step up, but
I was going to call you the best caster out of, like, the worst casters, but I guess that doesn't work now.
You're the best tier 5 caster, Capitalist. You go, buddy. You go. Someday you'll get to tier 4. Someday.
It's almost as good as your play.
Listen.
I'm just kidding. You played fine.
Me and you were doing work, all right?
Dude, I didn't even know we had a team that game.
Me neither, man. Me neither. I thought it was 2v5. Actually, I thought it was 2v8.
Did we have, like, some grill on our team? I thought we had a grill.
No.
Okay.
No, there was no grills to be found. Oh, she's going to be mad now. Shatter Demon.
She really is. All right, I might have to. All right, can you cut that out? Cut that out. Hold on.
No. No, there's no bleeping in this studio, sir. Everything that you say is out there for forever.
Mercy on my soul.
Yep. It's on the internet forever. I hope you realize everything that you say is actually permanent. Like, it goes on the internet and then it doesn't go away. Yeah.
All right.
Now let that pressure sink in. Shadow Demon Sand King was banned out by Evil Geniuses. We got the Darkseer as well as the Lycan banned out by Team Vasavi. We've got the Centaur as well as the Dazzle is going to be picked up by them, while Invoker and Batrider is wandering into the hands of Evil Geniuses. So RTZ, once again, going to be playing the Invoker, and they're going to be able to turn that into a pretty spectacular single gank squad with the Batrider lassoing somebody into a Sunstrike. Easy peasy kills.
Yep. We'll see what happens. Invoker, RTZ, let's see. He's been practicing that forever. We'll keep talking about it forever. Radiant we got some nice bands out. Actually, three of the four bands are supports. And we're going to see, it's kind of change up. Well, let's go get to the AA and tree band. I like those bands because it actually couples well with the global presence. And then it feels like PPD has a global presence already with his tree. He's always invisible somewhere. And taking out is the Disruptor. And that's a hero that can actually pick off Batrider really easily and Invoker. And causes a lot of teams havoc nowadays. And the Potom was taken out. So good hero to mess up Invoker if you just roam on him. Invoker can get shut down if you just put a Potom plus Shadow Demon mid. And you can't do anything. Once the Invoker is kind of shut down in the early game, he just falls off heavily, it feels like.
And, that's a tactic we've seen before, not just specifically for the Invoker, but more the person who's playing the Invoker, RTZ. Teams have been kind of like running dual lanes in the mid just to be able to shut down RTZ early, because he oftentimes is turning that mid into a carry position. Right, so many different times, even if it is like some mids that don't necessarily have that, like it's easy to say like, oh, it's SF or it's Naga Siren, it becomes a carry, but he also turns other heroes that that aren't usually as carryable, I guess. We'll go ahead and say that's a word. You can't really carry as easy with those heroes, but he still makes it work, so leaving him alone, probably not the best idea. We've got a Wisp, and we've got an Ursa. Finally, Team Vasavi, they're going to take advantage of the 6.81 and grab an Ursa. Finally, we see this guy. I'm surprised it's taken so long. Meanwhile, Evil Geniuses, they're going to pick up a Witch Doctor as well as a Luna. Not really changing much in this new patch.
We'll see if... I don't like Io plus Ursa on Radiant side, but it can still work out. if you can get the tier one towers down. I'm going to see if they have enough aggression pumping out with the Centaur Ursa combo to actually get towers this game, because they have a Batrider who's really good at deep pushing. Zai's cast with a Witch Doctor is really amazing too. Normally he's always using it at the right time. So we'll have to see if they're able to put enough aggression to actually do enough work this game. And that's a pretty greedy pickup. One that reminds me kind of a lot of Roxkiss. You're playing a Morphling plus an Ursa. That's a lot of greed.
That really is. I'm thinking dual lanes here, right? Run the Whispers in the middle, Dazzle, Centaur, and the off, and run Morphling safe lane. Thoughts?
No.
No.
Awful.
Instantly shut down.
Awful. No, I'm just kidding. It's not bad. Yeah, it's awful, actually. I take that back. It's fucking awful. Okay, so the reason why it's not, I'll tell you why it's awful.
Why is it awful?
The Morphling, he needs a bottle. He needs a bottle, and he has to go. If he goes top lane, you have to start off with a Wraith Band plus Morph stats, else you're not going to be getting any last hits. And so he has to sort of go middle. I could see Io plus Ursa, or if he does go safe lane, he has to be in a tri lane.
Uh-huh.
Else he's not going to be getting that. And then Ursa with Io, I could see. But I don't think that Centaur Dazzle off lane is that great. But they're doing Enigma now, so they can play sort of greedy, unless you see the Zai Enigma, which we will, which he likes to do dual lane with like Universe off all the time.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah, watching that is always a treat, because you're kind of like, wait, what are you doing? You're pairing up with a hero when you should just kind of be doing your own thing. But we'll see what he does. And okay, so I didn't really think that Morphling versus Invoker would be that good for the Morphling. But are you saying this is going to be a fine 1v1?
Morphling versus Invoker.
Mm-hmm.
I think that would be bad for the Morphling, because you can harass, but as long as you can manage to pull the creeps and you can use your nuke out on the waves, you can get full rune control. And you like the drawings?
I do a lot.
I thought you were easily amused by something. PPD's gonna catch him out. Oh, what is PP doing? That is not good.
Bye, oh PPD. Man,
this is the second game in a row.
It's the same old trick that they've run before. Well, right, PPD is gonna feed away first blood. At least there was no snowball this time. But they're going to start this out by blocking out the jungle. Not a big surprise. Like, a lot of teams do this. Who is one of the faster junglers in the game? They just man with their way in and just throw down a bunch of wards all over the place. I like the ward spots, too.
Yeah, it seems like Vasa V, they have the mechanics down. And maybe they don't have enough individual talent yet. They just need to get more team fights, more games, and I think they can maybe be a good team. And so far, starting off 1-0 again, and let's see if they'll be able to know. Do they have enough tangos to eat through this, but they'd have to eat through this.
Yeah, they'd have to eat through two different, well, they might be able to take this big bad boy down.
Well, it doesn't matter, because two of these camps are going to be blocked. No, wait.
Either way. Zai's gonna be sad. What, you think you could put one maybe somewhere in this area?
Catch no. All three of these are gonna be blocked. Condolences, Zai. You're kind of dead.
Zai's not gonna be happy about one. He didn't even start with an early deny. He's too busy trying to find him, so now he can't even get like that advantage for one of the lanes or anything like that. So he's just gonna be playing in this area. This is now his playground. So. Hope you have fun, Zai. We'll see whether or not he goes into the enemy jungle, but I doubt that's going to happen. Universe, getting a little bit low there. Ryu's just going to sit here. He's going to run out of Firefly eventually. Universe tanking up now to get the aftershock. He's trying to teleport away, but it's not going to be in time. And two kills already for Vasa V. Making the tri lane work and catching out Universe's Batrider.
All right, I called it. You didn't. Your awful ideas. Morphling's mid still.
Yes. I know, Ryo. I know. When you said it, I was like, yeah, that's probably for the best. Just normal old lanes. I was just so stuck on the fact that somebody needs to dual lane up against Arteezy. But when they invade the jungle, though, this is perfect. Like you said, like the jungler was picked up. They invaded the jungle. They warded it out. And it also means that Batrider won't be able to do anything. Like, he has to be in this lane. He's not going to find any other experience. And it's a dangerous lane, too. Now being caught out. Couple right clicks, and they got him. Ursa, Scary as hero at level 3, man, mixed in with the Earth Shock, you now have the overpower with Fury Swipes. Vasav E punishing Universe heavily so far, and that is really going to be their setup hero. They need Universe to have a good amount of farm because they don't have any form of initiation besides him.
One good thing is that Invoker is kind of crushing middle lane.
Yes.
He's actually has perfect CS along with Luna. Both of them have perfect CS. So not too many times you see that in pro Dota. Semi-pro Dota.
Hey, am I dead? Oh.
Brown froze. Yeah, he wasn't even clicking anywhere. It was kind of confusing watching him.
Lycus can probably turn and hit him. Cold Snap is on cooldown for another 3 seconds. It's just hard when you go full agility, man. You're so damn weak. Arteezy, though, looks like he's going to be fine. Illusion Rune going to be picked up by our Centaur, who's currently sitting at level 2. And he's missing out a lot of free experience here by sitting on this rune, and he doesn't even give it up to the Morphling, who is still trying to work on his bottle.
He's going to have to use his waveform if he wants to get it, but if he uses that, then he's going to die to maybe the Cold Snap and Sunstrike. Mm-hmm. He has to play really careful here. And Universe is still using this Firefly. He has to feel so bad. This is why you don't play too greedy. You got punished offlane, punished in the jungle. But I still think it's okay since Lycus is, he just got his bottle. Centaur is level 3. Universe is still only 2.5, and he has 2 deaths, and this tower is about to go down.
Yo, Morphling doesn't need actually to pick up any CS if they're going to be able to take down towers. He's going to get a little extra gold here. Tubby.
Oh, I got a lag on my screen.
He's going to pick up that last hit, so an extra bit of gold going their way. So as much as the solos aren't working out right now for Vasavi, it's going well so far for their defensive tri-lane. We'll see whether or not they can turn that into any early action. The unfortunate thing here is with this block of the early ward placed by Universe, Zebra has no access to any extra experience, and we all know how important it is for Wisp to get to level 6 nice and early.
Enigma's level 3. This is not looking good. Batrider's level 3. I'm trying to see the upside here, but I think they can still come back. They're doing it early. Oh my god, they're doing it.
Oh, that's because you can, because of lifesteal. You can get a Morbid Mass so early that you don't need to have a Vlad's. I forgot about that.
They know. It's because they're not in the bottom lane. This is why it's really smarter than the check. I mean, nobody's in the bottom lane, so you don't know where the Ursa is. Versus is not bottom lane, free farming a lane. He has to be doing either that or the jungle. Roshan or the jungle.
So if Ursa now does a little bit of jungling, perhaps they can give them some supports, a little bit of farm at this bottom lane. As Universe is now completely rotated out, doesn't want to risk it anymore. And he's going to be sitting in the jungle that has been freed up a little bit more now that the counter wards have died.
Maybe they need PPD to go bottom lane, block, convert his Eidolons, and block a little bit. We're at this tier one tower bottom. Maybe so they can get the lane back. Because they did block this camp, so they can't actually pull. So they're actually going to get this creep wave. So Universe, who goes down, Centaur. Well, that's your job. What are you doing, Cap?
What are you doing? I'm sorry. I'm just too busy listening to you, Ryo.
Thank you.
You know, I could be ignoring you, but
I would ignore me, actually.
I was just too deep in thought about what you were talking about. Baze Boots is now picked up by Ursa, making him damn scary. The problem is just experience. You take a look at the experience graph, sure enough, it is in the EG's favor, despite the fact that Vasavi do have a pretty decent gold lead, but it's ticking down quite heavily ever since the 3-minute mark.
That's actually really shocking. They have, oh my gosh, how are they winning in the EXP battle? That's kind of crazy, actually. Now middle lane Arteezy actually is going to go down. One more right click. Got him. Sniped.
Wisp comes in, helps out Lycus, and wins the lane against Arteezy. Perfect, because he was going to be going for a Midas. So they shut that down a little bit longer. Exactly what you want to see. Dazzle picking up a medallion. I like that idea, personally. Centaur trying to soak up some experience. He does have Tranquil Boots, and nice. He steals away the big old Centaur and takes some of that experience as well. So, going to be pretty happy with that one. They go back to Roshan, We did have a teleport. Our TZ's going to spy it out here, but I think it might be a little bit too late. It's already down to half, and once you get it to half, that's where you've got so many stats.
He didn't actually do it. He didn't click in the pit yet. It's going to go down.
Yep. Universe is coming in, but Tubby's going to be scoring so much lifesteal off of this. Here comes the Sunstrike. It's not going to be enough. He's getting extra. Aegis is picked up just in time. Universe trying to get out of the pit now. Luna, Mason, he made his way in. Pops the ultimate. Lycus trying to get away. He does have a waveform over the top of Luna, who's now going to get facing the wrath of the Urso. Comes back with that Aegis. No, the cask is bouncing around. It's destroying all of these heroes. They're trying to get out. Ryan slowed up by the Sticky Napalm. Zai will get there eventually with the Malifus. Cold Snap is actually first, and they will get the kill off of that. Oh, Centaur Ultimate actually going out. Sunstrike. Oh, Raya barely able to get away from that one in time. Zai's still going for it. He's got the Malphus left. He does have a Shallow Grave up on Raya. If he can duck into the trees here, possibly he can do a little bit of work. He just turns and fights. See if maybe he can get some sort of damage out on EG. But the five-manning of Evil Geniuses still means that Vasavi are going to be able to pick something extra out of the map, pushing in top lane as well as farming up the jungle with Ursa.
It was nice that they got that Roshan, but they ended up changing the Aegis, Morphling, and Dazzle. I think Wisp was able to get out. I'm not exactly sure. Wisp might have died on the back, too.
Golden Experience still went their way after that engagement.
Yeah. Well, that's a lot of EXP. That's because Centaur was top free farming, while Dazzle was kind of free farming bottom, but then you eventually came, so they were still free farming, and all the EXP was split, and you get the Roshan EXP. So that's why they came out pretty much ahead on that front.
And it was such an early Roshan, too. Gave him, like, every single player there in that Rosh pit got a level and a half, I think, off of that. So got to be happy. We now have Relocate is going to be up for Flying Zebra, so look for that with either the Centaur, who is actually a pretty good partner to pair up with, or obviously the Ursa is going to be usually a primary one. Relocate coming in on Mason. They're trying to help out with the support. Dazzle coming in. They're going to catch out PPD, but we do have Universe. That cask is bouncing around. Finally, it goes away. PPD trying to heal up as much as he can. Sunstrike trying to land on Zebra. Going to go away with that Relocate. Finally, Witch Doctor nice does go down, but they're stuck in a bad situation here. Railgun, he gets one stun. Tubby, he's having a hard time. He's just getting kited around by these Sticky Napalm. Starting to run away, but he's going to fall here. Raya, he's going to have to throw a Shallow Grave. Nope, the Eclipse comes in time.
What the hell?
A little bit of extra damage going down on the Batrider, but
can I alt-tap? Why did Wiz Taylor cancel?
I have no idea. I didn't see it. But yeah, that's fine.
I don't know. It was that now he's gonna get. I'm so confused. That seems like a bug or a glitch. He doesn't have enough mana for the Flaming Lasso. That was really weird. There was no reason for the tether to get canceled. I think he would have lived too on the. Or did he still live? Or did Ursa go down?
No, Ursa went down.
He's just so low level. He was like level 6 when he came back, and now he's level 7. He's
still in for Vlads.
Yeah.
Do you like that?
It's a good team fight.
Yeah.
I think he doesn't need it, though. I think Blink is probably better. Just keep it. I think Mask of the Helm of Dominator is actually better. But maybe he wants to get some other item.
You almost said
orb.
Mask Madness. You want it.
You want it.
Mask of Madness, man. It'll be legit. The fastest, scariest Ursa ever.
Yeah, just imagine if you have overpower, already 6 charges on, and then you just wait till it almost grinds down to the max timer, then you just blink in Mask of Madness, then you can get 12 hits off and immediately, almost.
Illusion's going to be picked up here from Zebra refilling that bottle, but take a look at that experience. Once again, it drops down in the favor of EG. Still 1,000 lead for Vasavi, but they do have a 1 tower advantage for now. Zai's getting pretty farmed. He's already got a Blink Dagger if he wants it, but we're presuming that's going to be a mech, seeing as you could definitely use the extra bit of team fight right now. Centaur coming in, going to try and catch out. Enigma, we do also have... Yeah. Zai doesn't even try and he doesn't even flinch at that one. He sees the relocate. He knows he cannot turn that.
They're going to relocate on ulti going
yes,
down.
Yes, they are. Eclipse going down. That was the wrong decision to bring back that Ursa. He could have tried to get a tether just to the creeps. He wouldn't have lasted.
Mid
Eclipse
lane.
Would have killed
Mid
him. But
Arteezy's going to go down. So does the Shadow Priest.
Not worth it. Not worth it for Evil Geniuses there.
Quint and he dagger. Had his Midas up too. Now he's level 11 on this Morphling. And Invoker is actually only level 9. But he should get 10 once he gets back. But they get a tower top. And they even the towers out. But right now, they're just losing actually. And the Centaur has a Blink Dagger. That's going to be doing a lot of work. But the mech on the Enigma, they should be able to team fight now better. Because they have Enigma with mech and Witch Doctor with the heals of the Voodoo. And should be enough, I think. Unless they just keep getting picked off with the relocates.
Yeah, the next relocate going to be up here in just another 15 seconds. We'll see who tries to set that one up. They just need to, like you said, just constantly get those pickoffs because right now the Morphling is in the best position of his life right now. He's sitting at a good amount of farm, sitting at 5k. He's keeping up with Arteezy as well as Mason. And he is going to be a damn scary carry if we can just delay this game long enough for him. My biggest concern right now is the fact that Ursa, especially with that last death being brought in by Zebra, he's very far behind from what was a free farm lane for him.
I'm also worried about the pushing. They have Centaur Blink to counter-initiate all this, but they have the Forge Spirits. They almost have the Necro Book 1. He might actually go 4 stuff, I'm not exactly sure. But mid lane, actually he's going to get caught out. Oh, no.
Oh, the Stomp completely whiffs. We do have 2-man Teleport coming in. They needed to hit that stomp and try and burst down Arteezy as fast as possible because Evil Genius is quick on the response there for the counter gank. Oh, Tubby wants to go on PPD. He knows there are some teleports in the middle lane, so there's not going to be a whole lot of response if they do dive the tower. But Flying Zebra really wasn't ready for that one. Tubby keeps on going for that tier 1 tower. We do have some heroes coming in right now. Railgun, he's trying to go in, but Universe is going to catch him out with the Blink Dagger, pulling him back right into Luna. Centaur Ultimate being popped. Relocate away. Nicely done. The tower will fall. The Tubby, though, now he's going to be stuck.
He's going to go down probably again. Does he have Ghostwalk? He has it, but there's a Sentry. Another Sentry. Get the hit. The hit. It got him.
Oh, we barely got him. Now the Wisp is going to come back in. Tethers does what he can, but Evil Genius is already setting up the trap, so they lose two heroes at top. They saved the Centaur, but they killed Arteezy, and they got 2 tier 1 towers off of that. I gotta say, I think that's worth it for Vasa V, especially since, you know what, the Ursa, he's already kind of fallen by the wayside a little bit. But as long as we get this Morphling nice and big early, it's all gonna be worth it.
I didn't think these 2 hard carries would be working out for him, but the Ursa is applying enough pressure. Sad to say that he doesn't have enough levels, it feels like. And he should probably get a magic one versus a Batrider, which I noticed they haven't gotten. And maybe Enigma, actually. Bye-bye.
Oh, God.
No,
they can't go for him. Mech is already being popped. Arteezy teleported in as well. Maybe if they had, well, Morphling, actually. He doesn't have maxed out adaptive strikes, so he's not going to be that helpful. We do have a Blink Dagger up, though. Now for Tubby. So we've got that extra bit of form of initiation. If they catch a hero who doesn't have some sort of disabled or goner, if they catch him out as some sort of a counter initiation as well, this Ursa is going to be just tearing heroes apart. Does jump in, trying to go on Zai, finish him off real quickly, gets the kill, and now Zebra coming in. He does have a relocate. He might just try and save both of them here. Centaur Ultimate going up. Ursa's going to town here on both Arteezy as well as Mason, but with the good Ghost Walk, make sure they will fall. Zebra now being dragged back into Mason, who will score a double kill off of that one, getting a mega kill streak now.
See, this is the difference between a high-skill team and a low-skill team. Okay, so they have 2 TPs on Centaur and on Morphling. If they had both TP'd bottom, they could have gotten at least a team wipe, I feel, and a... because that Ursa went ham in that fight, and he killed off the Enigma with the mech going off. Zai should have probably turned around to Malphite, but he didn't, so... I think if they just had more rotations, they could have definitely took that team fight, but they didn't, so still more space created for this Morphling, who will be going for a straight shotgun. He's got 2700 saved up, and Arteezy might get picked off here. He will not.
Yeah, look how low he is. If only Morphling was just heading up. Instead, he's trying to pop the stack real quickly. He does have that replicate up. So even if he is in a little bit of trouble here, he just jumps away and will be fine. So he steals a little bit of the stack, but also weakens it up for Mason to finish it off. He even says thanks for it.
Thank you.
Good guy, Mason.
He's not really a good guy, though.
No, that's not true at all.
Let's be honest here. Wait.
He's a flamer.
It's okay.
No, he tweeted me the other day. He tweeted me the other day.
He tweeted you? Yeah. Dude, I wish fucking Mason would cheat me.
No, he tweeted me and complimented me.
Oh, my goodness.
I was like, is this real life?
Capitalist.
He was like, I flamed you in NEO, but I like your casting. I was like, is he being sarcastic? I can't tell. So hard to tell. Radiant's
bottom tower. Yeah, you never know when people are being serious. It's too hard on the internet.
Dude, Mike did the same thing. Those are like, that's like Mike and Mason. Both of them. I was just like, do they ever express real emotions or is it all just sarcasm?
I feel like Mike, for the first half of our lives together, he was sarcastic, and then I feel like maybe the last 3 months, it's been real.
He's turned into a. Oh, here comes the Ursa. Now the Centaur ultimate also going up, but where's the dust, man? They finally catch him out. Arteezy in some trouble. The stomp's going to go down. Arteezy will lose his life, but here comes Zai. Maybe thinking about that black hole first. They're going to finish off Tubby, though.
They canceled it. Wow. Universe, go you.
Universe, oh, he canceled the relocate with the flame break?
Yeah.
Nice.
They would have got out, too.
That's very well done. Because then it would just be the Wisp that went down, and that's perfect. That's a perfect trade. Raya is also going to get caught out. Beautiful flame break, man. That almost pushed him forward, but another double kill for Luna. Mason going to be able to have a very, very fast BKB at this rate, if he wants it. Well, actually, if. He's already got a Mithril Hammer, so of course he wants it.
So, not many times I can call out Arteezy, but since he's playing Invoker, I'm going to make sure to do so, so he'll correct himself.
Uh-huh.
See, that's when you're playing Invoker, sometimes you if you get initiated on like that, sometimes you get a panic button and you want to do Ghost Walk, but most of the times you want to always skill Deafening Blast. If he had skill Deafening Blast there, he would have knocked back three, he would have lived, and it would have given him his team enough time to actually set up.
Uh-oh, Universe.
He's going to go down.
Oh, man.
This Ursa is still finding a lot of pickoffs by himself. If he gets a BKB, he's actually going to be doing a lot of work in these team fights. So I'm kind of scared for EG still. Even though they are up three kills, both teams have easy Roshan lineup. So, and they have a mech now done in Centaur. And the Deathblade is done too. So it's actually a scary time for... Well, they're actually doing... Oh, okay, this is the not good.
Yeah, this is the...
This is too early. Go away, run.
This is way too early, right in front of their base. They haven't gotten a pickoff or anything like that. He does have the rest of his team trying to help him out here. It's just the Morphling, who was picking up a top rune, found a regen. So this time around, we're going to see a Necronomicon on Invoker. I know you wanted to see that before in an earlier game. Do you agree with this pickup for Arteezy?
Yeah, the pickup from Batrider on Universe. Will he get him over the cliff? No, he will not.
Not quite in time. He's still going to be cast up a little bit, but he's so damn tanky. Mason actually getting real low here. Waveform catches him out a little bit more, but now the heals. Ursa comes in, finishes him off. 951 gold to him. Oh, that's unfortunate. Zebra's going to be stuck on the cliff, but he's going to relocate forward into the black hole. Zai responds with perfect precision. PPD now laying down the law with that ward, but it's not enough damage, man. It's only level 1. Now Lycus comes in, he gets a little bit low off that Deafening Blast. Maybe they can pursue for more, but there was a buyback. They got to be careful with this one. One Night Pulse is so damn big, but Ursa keeps on going. Arteezy's going to fall. Triple kill for Tubby Fat, and it's going to be a quad kill. He's going in for more. Universe falls in the back, and it's a team wipe. Buyback from Witch Doctor.
That's a Roshan, too.
That's a Roshan, too. Vasa V, man, coming back. They were at a 4,000 deficit there to Evil Geniuses and over almost a 7,500 experience lead, but now it's all even. It's even Stevens because they're going to get Roshan. They have a bunch of room to farm. Beautiful, beautiful setup for Vasa V.
They have a scary late game, too. I mean, I'm actually starting to think that actually EG might get taken down this game.
Dude, me too.
Yeah, they have the Universe. They still have Universe with the pickoffs. He didn't have a four staff there. That's why that fight turned out so badly in the end. Mm-hmm. And Invoker, he's still a long ways. I don't know. He's not doing enough this game. And it's going to be kind of on the backs of Mason to carry them this game with the holes from Zai.
Sorry, I was just checking out real quick. Something else. Something else going on, Sky. We do have four staff finish up for Universe, so that is the big differentiating factor like you were talking about. Better pickoff potential, and we also have BKB up soon for the Luna. Not sure if you mentioned that, but that is obviously a big increase, especially since he's going to have his level 3 ultimate. So, but he still has a lot to be, like, even once he has BKB, that's what I love about this Ursa pickup, is that it is so good versus heroes like Luna, who use their BKB as a crutch. Like, then while they pick up the BKB, they're like, oh, I'm tanky, but not to that physical damage. And if you do have a really good hero like Ursa, is a great example, just lays down a good amount of physical damage in a short amount of time, it's perfect. Luna is going to drop to this guy, especially since he, my God, look how much farm he has. He has a Desolator. Like, heroes fall.
He didn't even need to go BKB. I mean, RTZ, this is actually the one game you need a 4-staff. You need a 4-staff. If one time in your life Invoker needs a 4-staff, this is the game. They have Stampede. Uh-huh. They have too much chase, and you have to have it. And mm-hmm. This Morphling is just going to get out of control now.
That's why I asked you about it earlier, because I was like, up against an Ursa, I'm not quite so sure that you really want to be doing this. Ursa is going to start beating on the tower. Look at it, just getting chunked down. The Desolator is doing work to it right now. Ursa is going to clean that one up. It's actually picked up by the Morphling, but that just means more gold into probably a Manta next, so you can split out from that E-Blade. A little bit of good stats as well. Or do you want to see like a BKB?
For who, Ursa?
For the Morphling. It's usually either Manta or BKB to help.
Oh, definitely a Lincoln's. They just need a Lincoln's. The only thing they have to worry about is a blink over the top from Batrider right now. Oh, okay. Everything else is pretty much useless. And with this, they can split push. Morphling. Phew, that was close.
Whoa, Ursa jumping in, going in deep. He's got the Aegis. He just wants to kill RTZ real quickly. Oh, Railgun, he didn't get the double edge. Trying to get a Universe, saves him though. Bringing him back. Railgun's going to be inside the base. He's going to die to this Eclipse. Well played by Evil Geniuses, getting that one pickoff, and the rest of Boss RV trying to get away. That was such a good save there from Universe. That double edge would have finished off RTZ, but a good lasso in time. Still chasing down these two supports. Ryan Noob is actually going to fall here. Malphus, he's just going to get chased down. Zebra, he just abandons his ally. But RTZ, where they have it. Oh, there's Dust. It was actually on the Wish. They still catch him, but the rest of Evil Geniuses on their way. There's a black hole up. If Zai can get close enough, relocate just to save the Ursa. And that means our poor little Wish will go down while they see the mass spam. If they can actually pull this off, I'm sure a stun's going to hit him. I'm sure they've got to be able to kill him before he gets over the tether. Jump away. The cask isn't in time. Universe still pursuing, though. Cask does bounce like his, but Universe going to get cleaned up. Tubby's getting there, and he's getting in those extra hits. Wicked sick now. Lycus keeps on moving forward, looking for those extra kills. He's hitting hard right now. And with the extra Wisp, giving him that extra movement speed, they're going to have that Enigma in a short amount of time.
Shotgun!
Shotgun, man. Oh my God. That cask is just destroying them right now.
Oh, no. PPD, I mean.
Ooh, PPD.
That's just a little bit of slow reflexes there from Ursa. Feels a little faster. I think he could have got him.
Unbelievable. 18 to 16, almost 25 minutes in. Baza V, they've got a 2,000 gold lead. They've got a 2,500 experience lead, and they're pushing into Evil Geniuses. That was just the setup with the tether there, getting Universe, that was a big pickup because now they've got a good amount of control. When Universe is down, where's the initiation for Evil Geniuses? They don't have anything to set up a good team fight, so they could just five-man in. Universe going to catch out Ryan Noob. That's going to be a simple, easy pickoff. As he drags him back into the rest of his team. Shallgrave going down, but there's got to be stuns. He can't even teleport out, actually. It's on cooldown.
Man, RTZ hasn't even hit a Sunstrike this game. That's just... You know, that's not a... It's going to be a long game when you can't even... Not just kidding.
Apparently, not only do we have the shotgun up on Morphling, but it's also up on Rio Burrows over here, who's firing shots left and right.
No, I'm just kidding. I'm just saying, they need Invoker to be snowballing, and he's not. This is what they need. If not, then he's basically going to be a useless hero. He does have his Necro Books, which has been doing work against the Morphling. I'm sad this Morphling is going for a Yasha, because he needs mana. He needs mana pool, which is why you go a Lincoln's all the time on the hero. Mm-hmm. But maybe he'll go back for it. Maybe not. What's he going to go? what's the courier gonna get? It's gonna get a, I guess a ring. Yeah, a ring. It's gonna be going for a pipe. And once I have that pipe and a mech from the Centaur, I don't, unless Zai gets a 5-man black hole, they're in a lot of, they're in a world of hurt right now.
They really are. Zai is gonna be going for that BKB, in which case nothing will be able to stop him. If he does get that black hole, but he's not going to have that big jump. Right now, Evil Geniuses feeling they really need this pickoff. Universe is going to find somebody here. The question is whether or not Vasa B going to try and turn this Universe. Oh, Universe finally catches out the Centaur. And here comes that Meteor. Everything being laid down. But there goes the Shallgrave as well. Black hole being used just on Tubby. Take him down out of this fight. Invoker, he's got a double kill off of this fight. And now they're pursuing for more. Flying Zebra trying to get away. Does have a tether in 2 seconds, but the creeps are going to be up in 5. He needs something to tether to, but he's not going to get it. 27 well, minutes in, Evil Genius's smoke gank turns out well.
Proven wrong once again. And always, always, always. I mean, it's to be expected. The Morphling kind of misplayed there. He went in, immediately died to the Luna Eclipse. Luna Eclipse does a lot of damage. You can't forget that. They have no BKB still. They don't have the pipe to counteract. And they still do have a lot of pickoff and fight control. The Morphling went in that last fight and got a deafening blast very unluckily. But now they're going to get this tier 3 tower. They don't have buybacks on the Ursa, so there's actually no point for Morphling to buy back here.
I don't think they're going to be able to get the racks, but they will get tier 3. Well, Manta coming out from Mason. That's going to be a good amount of damage. 5 seconds, they'll get the range racks and melee, actually. But the question is, can they actually catch him out? Vasa V, they do have that center ultimate. They can go into the pursuit here. PPD, he's going to get caught. Evil Geniuses seem to be just letting him go here. Just say, see you later, man. We got what we wanted. You're just going to have to be sacrificed in exchange for what was a big turnaround from them, all coming from that smoking.
But yeah, that's like one little pickoff. One little pickoff, you transition into a Rax because they have Enigma, they have Luna, they have Invoker. One little mistake, and you're on the back foot for the rest of the game. And that was a 6,000 gold swing in the span of at least 2-3 minutes. And now they're going to have to bank on this next Roshan after they get their BKBs. I think even Morphling needs a BKB. I don't like this Manta pickup. Screw the Manta. It's not going to be doing that much work. Screw the Lincolns. You just need a BKB to team fight against this Luna and her ulti.
Yeah. Like when you said Lincolns, I was like, oh, you know what? You're right. It's the pickup potential of Universe, but BKB just seemed against this, man. If you really want to be going full shotgun, you're going to need a BKB. Otherwise, you're just going to get blown up by all the surrounding magic damage that's flying around. And on top of that, like, the Eclipse is going to be countering out the Morphling a lot if he's trying to be heads up in these team fights. And then on top of that, it seems like Black Hole is just going to be used every single time on the Ursa. And it makes sense. Like, once the Ursa's down, there's not much to really stop them.
Right now, BKB is up for Ursa. That's one good thing. Now he can go ape in the fights, but then Universe, all Zai has to do is just use his Black Hole, which he now has an Ag, so that's going to be doing a lot of damage, actually. Does it reduce your cooldown? No, it doesn't. I feel like Ags on Invoker should reduce your cooldown.
Purely Midnight Pulse, but I didn't even think about this upgrade. When Midnight Pulse is made such a huge AoE, it also increases the Ags, which throws down a Midnight Pulse, I'm presuming.
Lag.
It says it throws down. Whoa, Tubby going in deep here. Trying to catch out Mason, but Universe is going to grab him with the lasso. Now they turn around the Eclipse. Black hole, Morphling disappears. Centaur goes down as well. Tubby's still alive, but can't quite kill anybody. Universe went really low. Arteezy went really low. But it looks like that is going to be the end. Vasa V, they staged their last stand there, trying to get aggressive on Evil Geniuses instead of letting them just walk into the base. It was a good plan, but honestly, Evil Geniuses just executing way better in the team fights. And that means the second set of racks is going to go down, and I'm sure probably a GG call here from Vasa V, because it's not just going to be this mid racks. It's probably going to be either thrown or they take tier 2 and then take the top racks.
Yeah, even though EG lost earlier to Alliance, they do look a little bit mortal. I think this game came down to just a little bit of the drafting side. They got outplayed early because of the laning stage, but then they came back eventually, and Raya's going to go down, and that's going to be game. I I do like the comeback though from EG, just to show that they can come back from having like one of the most horrible starts I've seen in a long time.
Yeah.
Vasavi, they did what they could, man. You gotta give them props. I don't think anybody expected them to do this well up against a team like Evil Geniuses. So certainly some things to work on. A little bit more experience, but all around, a very, very well done job by Vasavi doing what they could up against the Titans Evil Geniuses and drafting well for it as well. So well done by them. They are going to be knocked out of the ESL 1 Frankfurt US qualifiers. Evil Geniuses are going to be the ones to move on in the brackets, and that means they are going to be facing the winners of our next match, which is going to be North American Rejects versus Revenge. Now, if this looked a little bit one-sided to you, I'm thinking North American Rejects versus Revenge is going to be a lot more even. There's a lot of talent on North American Rejects, but they're a new team. They got a lot of kinks to work out, as well as while they did have, like, a lot of talent, a lot of them are really, really rusty. While Revenge, they've been the tried and true team from South America, just always being able to provide upsets left, right, and center. So they are definitely a solid team that has been around for a very, very long time. So opposite sides of the field. Rio, you got any last words about this this series between Evil Geniuses and Vasavi?
I just think they should have let the Centaur initiate more fights than the Ursa. Sure, Ursa got more pickoffs early game because he initiated, but if they had the Centaur maybe getting three-man stuns, they could have set up a lot more. But they were being a little bit too aggressive, I want to say, just with the Ursa and not setting up enough combos with their Centaur, because that was really their only initiation. And then maybe they could have played a little bit more shotgun down the hero instead of fighting so much and then try to kite people around. But it was really well played. Good black holes by Zai, and good team fight control. And I think Mason played played the best. Because he definitely did carry this game.
Oh, yeah. He did an excellent job farming. Wasn't in too many bad team fights. And, his team did a lot to set up a lot of free kills for him. But he didn't really. He took that gold and turned it into something good. So, well done by Mason, the rest of Evil Geniuses. Now, guys, we do have. It's going to be about a 25-minute break until the next match. We scheduled it early, but the series was pretty quick. So, next series coming up, just 25 minutes, North American Rejects versus Revenge after a 25-minute break.